Today's lecture 6 of basic electronics is about operation of the mobile phone.
Welcome to our channel Class Fly Community. So today is the most interesting topic because the thing which we'll today learn is about a particular thing which without which we can't live our life. So basically we'll understand with this that we will be dealing with the topic, the principle of operation of mobile phone. See, we know that mobile phone are help us to contact to any number of people at simultaneous times, right? At any place. So it is basically helpful to us digitally, as well as we can communicate with any person at any country. Right? So today we will see how it operates. So before that, we should know that a cell phone offers full duplex communication. Full duplex communication means that in a full duplex communication, both the parties can communicate simultaneously. Think that me and my friend want to contact each other, so we call each other, so we are communicating to each other and we are receiving the talks from each other to know about how we are in this current situation. So in full duplex communication, both the parties can communicate simultaneously. That means he also can say to me as well as I also can say to him or her, whatever, right? There is a separate channel to send and receive information. In this full duplex communication system, there will be a separate channel from which we can send and receive information. Okay? That means people can listen to each other simultaneously. As I told, both of them can talk to each other, can receive the information to each other at the similar time, right? So, as well as a cellular phone provides standard telephone operation. So it will provide a operation which is very standard. Okay, basically this cellular phone or mobile phone is a two-way device. How it is a two-way device? I will be transmitting some information and the other party will be receiving the information. So the transmission is the one form and the receiving is the another way. So it is a two-way device. So in simple words we can say basically it is a two-way device consists of a radio transmitter and a radio receiver. Now we will know what the we are knowing now this about this cell phone and its duplex communication, but do we know what mobile phone is? So the next part is, what is a mobile phone? See, a mobile phone is an electronic device used to communicate over a cellular network. That means mobile phone is used for communication to any part of the country or any place, and it will be done with the help of a cellular network. Mobile phone provides a wireless connection, right? The mobile phone which we have, we doesn't have any wire, so that means it is wireless connection. And it is connected to the public switch telephone network. That means there is a public switch telephone network to which it will get connected and to found the user location within the radio range of the system. So this is a telephone, it is an electronic machine, and it will be only help us to communicate over a cellular network, and it is a wireless connection. It will first connect to the PSTN for the user location, which would be within the radio range. Okay, now let's move on to some terms which we need to know for this principle of operation of the mobile phone. The first term is that it is cell. Okay, see, we can contact to any people anywhere, right? So every place must have a particular areas, so that area is in mobile phone operation term is known as cell. So in simple words we can say that I have also written what I told, that any people can contact anyone through cellular network, right? Every place has been divided in area, so that area is known as cell. And in simple words, you can write that a basic geographical unit of a cellular communication system is known as cell. But cell must be symmetrical in shape. Cell must have a symmetrical shape, and these shapes are divided in four. That is, first is circle, then is square, then is equilateral triangle, and then it's hexagon. So let's take a assumption that there are two circles, but its areas are not so vast, so the connection may fail. So most preferably hexagon is used because it is far from each other. So preferred cell shape is hexagon. Okay, now we will move on to our next term, which is, so our next term is the cluster. Cluster means is a group of cells. So it will be a group of cells. Okay, this one part is our cell. I hope you all understand the terms. Now we will move on to the mobile phone system. Okay, see, this is our mobile phone system. This is a drawing which I have made for you all so you can understand properly. Okay, so see, this all these type of antennas, you may be thinking, is our BTS. BTS here means base stations. See, first when we give a call, when a call is set up, basically it moves to the BTS. BTS means the base station, then base station of particular areas, and then it will move to the central base station. From that central base station, it will move to the MSC. MSC means mobile switching center. From there, it will move to the another part, mobile switching center, so to get contact to the other MS. From there, the reverse process will occur. That means as we move from MS to BTS, then BTS to BSC, and then we came to MSC1. But when it moves to another part, MSC2, it moves from MSC to BSC, BSC to BTS, and then MS. Okay, so MS here is our mobile station, and BS or BTS is our base station, and MSC is our mobile switching center. So I have also written here that when a call is set up, first signal is sent to the BTS, that is a base station, and from there it moves to the BSC, that is the central base station, and then it moves to the MSC. Basically, MSC is the master control of all the systems. Okay, see, now mobile station. So mobile station is nothing but a mobile phone which the user uses. That means the mobile phone that you are using or I am using, right? And each mobile station has an antenna, right? And a control circuitry as well as a transceiver. Okay, so this is a basic definition, you can say, for a mobile station. Okay, now see, we studied that the first signal moves to the mobile station, then it moves to the base station. So we have to also define that what is base station. See, base station also contains antenna, a controller, and a number of receivers, because it is not a particular mobile phone. It is a bridge between a mobile phone users in this cell. Okay, and so there are a number of receivers. So it connects the simultaneous call via telephone, right? Telephone lines to the MSC. Now from MS, that is the mobile station, it will move to BS, and from BS it will move to MSC. Okay, so as I told, from base station it will move to the mobile switching center. What does mobile switching center do? It connects the calls between the mobile units. That means if I call someone, it will connect my call to that person mobile phone. Okay, and it also coordinates the working and the activities of the base station, and then it connects the entire cellular system to the PSTN. PSTN, we know that it is public switch telephone name. PSTN work is that it basically turns the human the voice that I am saying so that the other person can receive the same content whatever I am saying. That means it works on the basis that the human voice must be recognizable to the person to whom he or she is speaking. Okay, so I hope you understood the principle of operation of the mobile system, how it works. And so whatever I told, you can write in your as a notes. So first we know about the cellular network and what does the cell phone is, how is operated. Then we knew about the what is mobile phone. Then we came to know the diagrammatic structure, how it moves from the MS to the BTS or BS, and then it moves to the BSC, and then it moves to the MSC. So this is particularly operation of the mobile phone. So today's lecture ends here. Till then, be happy and have a great day.
Now is the code time. All life is an experiment. The more experiments you make, the better. I hope all of you understood today's lecture, and thank you for watching.
Wow, wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at Class Like Community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.